Hello everybody. In this video, I'm going to be doing a review of the Jeevan Tarun plan. Now this plan has been recently introduced by LIC on Children's Day, and we've been deluged with calls and texts from parents asking us whether this is a good plan to help save for child's higher education. What is this plan all about? Well, this is an investment-linked insurance plan where essentially we're investing for a specific period, and then beyond that period, you're going to be getting a yearly payout for, let's say, 5 years. So for example, you are investing for a 20-year period, and then from the 21st to the 25th year, there is going to be a payout that's going to come every year that you can use for your child's education. So first, let's understand the basics. The first thing is that the life coverage is on the child and not on the parent. Coverage on the child is not really a very, very good idea. Secondly, the amount is going to come from the 20th year to the 25th year. And there is going to be a final bonus, which is not assured at this point in time. So as always, we put in the numbers on a spreadsheet, and clearly a lot of people love buying insurance because the agent tells them that aap itna daloge and aapko itna amount aayega. So what happens is that people feel, oh okay, I'm going to be putting this amount and I'm getting a very good amount back, but they really don't calculate what are the returns from the policy, which is very, very important to calculate. And the correct way to calculate this is through something known as the XIRR. So when we put these numbers in the spreadsheet, look at the return that we got. We got a princely return of 4%. Yes, you heard it right, 4%. Isn't that the savings bank rate? Wait a minute, why would you want to lock in money for 25 years and get a 4% return? And incidentally, you know, on Children's Day, I read an article which showed that the inflation on child education expenses is more than 10% per annum. So imagine you're putting your hard-earned money into something that's giving you 4%, but you need to be generating return above 10% in order for you to meet your financial goals. Folks, please wake up. These sort of policies are not the right way to go for investing for your child's education. It might sound good to say that money is going to double after so many years, but you need to necessarily calculate the rate of return. Please go through the policy illustration workings very, very carefully. One of the illustrations that we saw had some sort of double counting as well. So please be very careful when you go through the illustrations. Please ask your agent what is the return. You know, in most cases, they're just going to tell you, oh, you'll get an 8% return. You'll have to calculate the XIRR, which is by putting in the cash flows every year and then calculating the return. Let us see how the policy works with an example. So let us assume that you're buying the policy when the child is 5 years of age. The premium amount every year is going to be 1,17,000. So over a 15-year period, the premium amount is roughly going to be about 18 lakhs. More specifically, 17,72,000. Now the annual survival benefit is 10% of the sum assured for a 5-year period starting from the age of 20, and the sum assured in this case is 19 lakh rupees, which means that over a 5-year period, the amount that's going to be returned is going to be 9.5 lakhs. There is a bonus which is declared in the 25th year, but this of course is not a guaranteed bonus, and it really depends upon the market conditions and what the insurance policy has really earned. It really depends based on that. Now, when we put all of these workings together, what we find is that the overall returns work out to 4.46%. A better way to invest for your child's education would be through Sukanya Samriddhi scheme if it's a girl child, or even PPF if you're really very, very conservative. Of course, if you can take risk and you're willing to invest for a 20-year period, then your ideal investment needs to be equity funds. And if you don't know which fund to choose, just go for a Nifty 50 index fund or a FlexiCap fund. Honestly, that will give you much, much higher returns, and the chances of it beating the child education inflation is also very high. Keep checking out our videos to know the right places to invest. Do click on the bell icon to subscribe. Till then, bye-bye.